Warning, the content of this video is very graphic in nature. A trip to hell. The Lord said, there are so many people like them who walk on the path of hell that it is countless now. These people are following the path to hell without any awareness that their destination will be hell. The story of the artist who drew about hell. May 22, 2009. It was on the 12th night of 100 days of all-night prayer. The words, "It's hot," came out of my lips, and I realized that my spirit was going through the sufferings of hell. Then I saw a series of 4 images. I realized that this woman had been a woman with many sexual experiences. I realized that this man had been a man who had committed sins with his lips. Demons ripped off the flesh of the man's spirit, roasted it, and enjoyed it as food. These were lost souls who had just landed in hell. Then I saw a black factory far in the distance. I soon realized that these souls will soon undergo tortures of hell there. The feeling of intense fear and dread did not leave me. Even by then, I did not know why I saw those things. My heart grew hot from praying all night. As an artist, I was inspired to let people know the heart of the Lord in this time period through my paintings. So I expressed my desperation to my pastor and asked for his prayer and advice. People tend to think that heaven and hell are only a conceptual world of dreams. However, the spiritual world is a world of reality that actually exists. The mind, thoughts, and the hearts of the body are transferred directly to the spirit. So the pain of hell is felt as if one would feel physical pain. Also, the spirit can sense things just as the physical body can, but it can feel things more sensitively and more intensely. The joys of heaven and the pains of hell can also be felt much more intensely than one would in a physical body. Heaven and hell actually do exist. A video of heaven or hell cannot be recorded and brought back, so the Lord showed what they are like through these paintings. The paintings you are about to see are actual scenes from the various parts of hell that I expressed through these paintings. Hell for murderers. There were outcries from souls who were being cut like slabs of meat all over the place in the human meat market. The flesh were being cut and hung throughout the place, and a huge demon with a beast-like face held a big knife. He then put the flesh meat on top of the cutting board and began to cut on it. The cut slabs of flesh screamed out in pain and begged to have their life spared. The first murderer in the Bible was Cain. And the reason for that was jealousy and envy. Hell for jealousy and envy. Demons threw people in hell one by one over the cleave that connected to the floor below. and slid them down on the fluid that secreted from the walls like water slides. The people who received the suffering of being thrown over the cliff are people who felt neglected in love and felt left out. On the floor, on the basement section of hell, there was a huge shovel that was placed on a rock like a seesaw. On that shovel, there was a person sitting there, tightly bound and trembling in fear. There was a fat but nimble demon, and the moment he jumped up and down the handle of the shovel, the man screamed and flew high up in the air and disappeared. Hell for those who commit sins verbally. Jesus then said, "For those who cut me to pieces, disregard my words, and speak recklessly, their tongues will be hammered with big nails. Their lips will be sewn together with needles, and lava will be poured on their tongues." Hell for slanderers. The Lord then said the psychology behind slander is that it does not stop at the instant one hears it, but rather it gets relayed to another person and so forth until it becomes a widespread rumor within moments. The tongues of people who make slandering their duty are similar to the tongues of Satan. One mistaken slander will cause both the slanderer and the victim to undergo suffering that comes from slandering. Slander is a habit. It's a satanic trait of taking pleasure in speaking ill of others. I, the Lord, say unto you to please eliminate the seed of such slander. Torture for liars. The demons kept shoving rocks into the mouth of the man. The man threw up and cried out in pain, but the demons kept shoving these hot rocks without a moment of rest. Complainers. I saw a man who was being strangled and tied with a snake, and a long thin snake was wriggling inside his stomach. Numerous men lay on the floor with a robotic facial expression as if they had no thought in them. Their faces were pale and gray with their eyes staring blankly. I then heard a noisy sound in my ear. That noise was truly like the sound of hell that I had heard on the internet. And it sent shivers down my spine, for it was a noisy and dreadful sound. When I listened closely, I heard that there were voices of people who were grumbling and complaining. It is the Lord's fault, it is God's fault, it is your fault, it's all the pastor's fault. I heard every one of them complain that it was someone's fault. Their complaints were so loud that it hurt my ears. They looked so unsightly that I had to quickly glance at the Lord's face. This is what the Lord said. The Lord said they did not say with words, but they always had negative words and thoughts. And they had stubbornness stored in their hearts. Just because it is not spoken does not mean that sin was not committed. It is sin even to keep it within your heart and without resolving and repenting of the things that are in your heart. Hell for those who commit suicide. One man's story. His was that of continuous stress. Oh, I'm so tired and exhausted. Wherever I go, there's no place where I can feel at peace. I've tried to suit myself with drinking. I don't want to live anymore. Will everything be peaceful once I die? Will the weight of this life be lifted off me once I die? And he jumped. Where am I? Demon replied, so you thought that it will be over once you die? You thought you will be happy once you die? Oh, if I could only go there. Those who are in hell know that there is heaven. Yet they also know that no matter how much they cry or repent, they can never go to heaven. Hell is a world of eternal regret and suffering. Hell for addicts. Extensive use of the internet leads to wrong communication, games, pornography and other addictions, and it can cause confusion between the virtual world and reality, violence, sexual perversion and other crimes. Therefore, it can be the major cause that leads people to sin. Hell, for drug addicts, was a very cold place. Demons cut off the people's arms and legs, buried them in ice, and tied the rest of their body to a tree with ropes. Hell for materialistic people. These people loved money when they were physically alive, but they receive eternal suffering here in hell. The Lord then said, these people were so caught up in their pursuit for riches that they valued money more than people. They preferred luxurious imported cars over faith and mock churchgoers. They also live in fear that the food that Satan pours on them will vanish, so they try to fill their greed for possessions. Just as they were once sophisticated, Satan raises them high on pedestals and burns their whole body to flames, where they will live in intense and extreme pain. Hell for those who commit sexual sins. Even if love was done out of mutual affection, it was done outside the law that the Almighty God had given to humans. So it's considered as sexual sins. People commit sexual sins, but they believe that it's just one of the ways of life. Love that is neither sincere or for salvation of lives, but done simply for their own pleasure is considered to be sin. The reason is that our bodies were not created as tools for pleasure. Hell for those who commit sexual sin. A woman and a man had all their limbs spread apart and bound in the nude. They were hung high up. The demons had 2 to 3 meters long spears and pierced them puk puk into the genitalia of the woman and the man again and again. A long and thin snake that was over 15 meters entered into the woman's private parts within seconds and passed through her whole body until it came out of her mouth. Men were stuck on the wall of the pit like human bats, and beasts that looked like hyenas were gnawing at their penises. The men that were stuck on the wall screamed in unbearable pain. Those who make pornography. There was a machine and a person was bound with his limbs spread apart. When the machine began to run, the hands and feet which were bound began slicing off. The torso that had been cut up were gathered in one pile. The body was sliced thinly and passed through the machine like a bank receipt running through a cash register. People who had sexual intercourse with animals. The people were hung upside down and twisted continuously until blood dripped from them and fluids oozed out from them. These lost souls in hell screamed for their life to be spared, but I saw demons below them collecting the dripping blood and drinking. Women who enjoy sex and abort babies recklessly. A woman was hung upside down in a deep pit. 10 demons inserted 10 20-meter long spears into the woman's private parts all at once and twisted, tearing them inside her. Hell for those who have abortions. There was a silk worm-like fruit on a bare leafless tree. A naked soul was curled up inside that fruit like a fetus inside a womb. There were sharp thorns made of steel embedded in the fruit, and this pierced into her body. So she bled in miserable pain. This place was filled with people who chased after their own pleasures, did not bear any children, but kept aborting them. Harming lives is a tremendously horrific scene of murder, so we have to quickly repent. Those who masturbate. The Lord then said to her, "You who cannot overcome Lucifer's tricks and succumb to masturbation. There are so many of you who cannot overcome its pleasures and commit this act habitually. You did not realize the essence of love, nor can you feel an abundance of love in spirit. You are people who think that physical love is everything. When it comes to love, the love of the heart, mind, and spirit is the greatest. The rotten love of the lower body is actually a love that is dead. Those who masturbate. Demons put a man on top of a big cutting board and began to cut the man's penis. The man screamed, and his whole body began to convulse. One woman was stripped naked and dragged on a floor of hard, sharp rocks. This woman was unable to overcome her desires and tried to satisfy her physical desires through masturbation. They fall into the pits of hell because they did not perceive it as sin. The Lord said these people committed all kinds of filthy and wicked acts. These are people who lived a life of human trash in the gutter of iniquity. Among them there are also famous entertainers, and there are many people who live being caught up in drinking at bar lounges and sexual pleasures. With gutter-like acts they had committed, they are undergoing punishment in the gutter of hell. These people had tried to kill themselves and beat themselves every day. They lived a life of self-condemnation, they hit others, were violent, and fought with others. These people lived a life of killing others in their hearts and with their words, hundreds of times at a time. The Lord said to her, "So many people in this world are corrupt from the fall, so please relay my ever-aching heart to them." Even at this very night, masses of people commit sins again and again, and they are born again as ones who have lost value. Hell for children. Lord, how old is this child? The Lord said, "This child is 9 years old and was an elementary school student." Lord, why is this child going through such suffering? I really couldn't believe that a child was in hell, and it was truly dreadful. The Lord said this child did the things that his parents told him not to do, and Satan was using this child the whole time. He was foul-mouthed and already caught up in the sexual culture of adults even at such a young age. Therefore, his brain was already plagued with a disease to the point that even his parents could not help him fix it. There were bugs and insects crawling around this child, and they were eating away at the fully naked child. Lord, what should we do with young children? Wouldn't it be okay if they repent? The Lord replied, "If children can discern between good and evil, know about heaven and hell, and judge for themselves, and yet become corrupt and fall into the domain of sin, regarding sin as trivial, harming others, mock and slander others, with no intention to repent, they will end up in hell." There are so many children like him in the world. If these children do not repent and get into an accident or become ill, then die, demons will drag them away and confine them to various prisons of hell. Hell for pastors who have become bad. The demons were dancing with joy. Today a big person came, he's the pastor who used to harass us. His whole spiritual body was tied up with rope and dragged there. Ah! Demons held up arrows with very sharp metal tips that were heated over the fire and began scaring him by stabbing him all over his body again and again. Ah, please, Lord, please save me. The demons replied, it's useless now. You are now ours. Lord, why is this person here? Jesus replied, he once led a mid-sized church. He specially received the grace of God and began leading a church. He preached about heaven and hell to many lives, but later on, he gradually, little by little, became corrupt. He was a married man, but he seduced one young woman from his congregation, dated her, and began to forget about me. Soon after, he began hitting his wife and ended up living with the other woman. He was then driven out of church. Even when times grew hard, he did not seek me. He rejected my help even when I had tried to give him many chances and bring him back. I had wanted to lead many lives to the path of salvation through him, but he turned everything away and chased after his own desires. That is how he ended up here. Lord, what type of suffering will he be going through here? Demons hate and despise mostly the pastors or anyone who once did my work, so they will inflict on them all kinds of pain. The demons will be happy and relieved that they fell for their tricks. This place is a hell for people who do not or hate to attend church. Even if they attend a church, they attend a church half-heartedly. Those who mishandle public funds. A man was standing naked with his two arms spread in the image of a cross. There were needles pricked into each of his cell all over his body. He looked as if he could not scream. Even if he was in terrible pain, this person had spent the church funds as if it was his own. Those who do not preach the gospel. Those who hated the word of God. There was a person who kept vomiting. I looked closely and saw that small baby snakes were popping out of her mouth. This person had hated the word of God. The word is food for the spirit. Our spirits grow and change through the word of God. There are those who confess their love only with their lips, but fail to give their heart to Jesus. Jesus said, these people have not even once given their heart to me, and only looked upon me as their neighbor. They did not love me. They called on me, but only did so because they had to. They never cried for me, but only cried for themselves. The modern people see, hear, feel, and meet whatever and whoever they want, and their hearts and bodies get caught up in these things. So even when it is told to them that there is a creator who created human beings, and that spiritual world exists, they neither have the time to think of that world or show interest. It can be expressed that they live the way they do because they do not know the realities of the spiritual world. You need to realize this instant that the result of such a life will lead you straight to hell. Those who lived in this world, having nothing to do with me, when they die, they will also go to a place where it has nothing to do with me. Path to hell. Path to heaven. There are so many paths in this world, but they all are ultimately two paths. It may seem that life consists of thousands of paths, but everyone, when they die, will have to choose between two paths. Heaven or hell. What determines your fate of going to heaven or hell is your life here on earth. Indeed, it may seem that life consists of thousands of paths, but everyone, when they die, will have to choose between two paths. Just as gender, male or female, is determined in the womb, it is the womb of earth that will determine the world where our spirit will reside. Everyone's physical body is born once and faces death, but as people fated for death, our spiritual life is the outcome of our physical life. The Lord said, "My heart aches when the ones who I govern live in the midst of sin. They do not even know that it is sin until the sins they commit pile higher and higher and becomes a tall, strong tower. But I will forgive everyone who breaks down their tower, becomes cleansed, and comes to me. Your pains are my pains. Your suffering becomes my suffering. Everyone who lives in the midst of sin, quickly repent and come back to me." My path is straight and my bosom is wide and deep. I have expressed all of my love for all mankind. Repent sincerely so that you will not go to hell. Those who feel it deeply in their hearts will strive with all their might not to go to hell. Tell them about this hell. Let it be known. It is appointed to men to die once, and after this, the judgment. At this point, I would like to present a life-changing opportunity to you. If you would like to invite Jesus Christ into your heart, why don't you pray this prayer right away, meaning every word? Please repeat after me. Lord Jesus, I come to you a sinner. I believe you died for my sins and rose again to make me right with God. Forgive me all my sins and wash my heart with your precious blood. Write my name in your book of life and help me to make it to your heavenly kingdom. In your name I pray. Amen.